And the other way to use the galvanometer to measure signals in DC circuits is to use the galvanometer as a voltmeter. So using the galvanometer as a voltmeter is relatively simple. Let's first denote these A and B terminals as the voltage to be measured, okay? And the galvanometer is connected to these terminals like this. And always we have the internal resistance of the galvanometer. And we must use an auxiliary resistance. This time we call this Rx. We must use this auxiliary resistance in serial to the galvanometer. And Rs usually is very large, much larger than the internal resistance of the galvanometer. Because if you know this current Ig deflects the galvanometer to the maximum position, okay, then you know we must use an auxiliary resistance, very large resistance, so that we can use the galvanometer as voltmeter. So this is the voltmeter, and this is the terminals A and B. Okay. So this is the way we use galvanometer to measure the potential difference between any two points like this A and B. And again, Ig is full deflection current. Okay. And we can express now the potential between A and B, the terminals A and B. This Ig, the internal resistance plus the auxiliary resistance Rx. And from this auxiliary resistance Rx is to be determined by this equation V minus Ig multiplied by Rg divided by Ig. Okay. So if you want to measure some voltage V, okay, you must use, or roughly you have to select a resistance by using this formula, okay? V minus Ig Rg divided by Ig. So this Ig is the current that deflects the galvanometer to the maximum position, and is always very small value. This is small, so also this is small. So if you want to measure some voltages, a voltage which is larger than this multiplication, this expression tells you that Rx must be very large resistance in compared to the internal resistance of the galvanometer, because in the denominator we have this full deflection current, and full deflection current is always much small in compared to this expression in the denominator.